Hi everyone, welcome back. If you're new here, my name is Smita. Welcome to my channel. Today I'm going to be showing you how I tone down my looks. Toning down to a point where I've lightened my hair color with highlights. If you haven't watched that video, I'm going to link it down below. And then I'm also going to tone down my eyebrows by lightening it. I'm going to be doing a quick wing using a sponge brush. It is easy, it's quick. You can do it in one swipe and it looks fantastic. So I can't wait to show you how I've packed everything in one tutorial. So if you're ready, let's begin. We'll start with lightening the brows, and for that I'm going to be using the Sally Hansen Bleach. If you're going to be trying this, make sure to do a patch test first. Here I've mixed two parts of bleach to one part of activator, and I'm going to be applying it on my brows. I'm going to first apply it in the opposite side of my hair growth, and then I'm going to apply it in the direction of my hair growth so everything is well saturated. I'm just taking off the excess with a Q-tip, and I'm going to let it sit there for about 8 minutes. I'm going to take it off with a spatula and then rinse it off with some cool water. And that's pretty much it. Here's the before. And here's how it looks after I've toned it down. It's very subtle, but at the same time, it'll soften any look. I've already prepped my skin, and now I'm using the Silk Peony by Tatcha to blur the fine lines and wrinkles around my eyes. To fill in all the fine lines and pores, I'm going to be using the serum stick again by Tatcha. This has a balm-like feel to it. This is a concentrated serum and it targets signs of aging and dryness instantly, especially if you have dry skin like me, and it keeps your skin looking fresh throughout the day. To keep my lips hydrated, I'm just using a lip balm. This one's from Milani. To color correct, I'm going to be using a new product by Milani. This is the Supercharged Brightening Under Eye Tint. Although it says under eye tint, you can use it as a brightener and a color corrector around your mouth, eyes, wherever you have hyperpigmentation or discoloration. And because this is such a light tint, you can barely tell even if it mixes with the foundation. So I'm not going to be setting it with any powder. For foundation, I'm going to be using the Rare Beauty Liquid Weightless Foundation in the shade 360W. And to blend it out, I'm going to be using a damp sponge. This one's from Ofra Cosmetics. As you can see, the texture of this foundation is amazing and it's very easy to blend, again giving that beautiful glow that I live for. Although at first I thought it was really watery, I didn't really mind it because it gives excellent coverage and the foundation feels really light on the skin. A little goes a long way and gives you that satin matte finish. To contour, I'm going to be using a deeper shade of concealer from ColourPop in the shade 200N. I'm just taking a little bit in the back of my hands, and then with a kabuki brush, I'm going to dab this mostly in the circumference of my face, in the hollows of my cheekbones, as well as jawline, just to give it some structure. I personally like cream contouring because it gives a more natural look and it's very easy to blend. But if you're not comfortable with cream contour, you can most definitely use powder contour. But make sure to set your face with powder first. Set the base makeup with either a translucent powder or a pressed powder, and then you can use the powder contour. And then for concealer, I'm going to be using my favorite Milani concealer in the shade 145. I'm going to be using this to conceal around my eyes and mouth, again blending it out with the damp sponge that I used for my foundation. I'm going to lightly set the concealer and in my T-zone with the Airspun Translucent Powder, and then I'm going to lock my base makeup in using the Benefit Super Setter. This is a setting spray usually used to lock the base makeup in, and it also melts all the powders on the face and makes your skin look more like skin, but just a better version. I really like how my brows look. What do you guys think? Let me know. But for now, I'm going to be using a lighter shade of the Precisely My Brow pencil from Benefit. I'm using the shade 4.5 because I've lightened my brows. I usually use a 6. I'm going to be filling in the top portion of my brows first and then use the spoolie to brush my brow hair upwards so I can clearly see at the bottom and fill it in. And then to keep my brows in place and to set it, I'm going to be using a setting gel by Laura Mercier. And this is a transparent gel, so it's not going to add any extra color to my brows. Today's eye makeup is my kind. It's super quick and easy. And I'm going to be using a neutral palette by Etude. This is the Milky Play Colors Eyes Palette. All I'm going to be doing is use the side of a sponge brush. I got this in one of the palettes. And I'm going to dip it in a deeper shade of brown. And I'm going to simply drag it in the outer edge of my eye. It packs in so much color, so even with one swipe, you can get a beautiful smoky wing. And to smoke it out a little bit more, I'm just going to rub it in the outer edge. And then with a blending brush, I'm going to blend it out in the inner half of my crease as well to balance it out with the wing. To highlight my inner corner and brow bones, I'm using the Revlon Skin Lights Highlighter. I'm going to curl my lashes and use a coat of mascara. The one that I'll be using is the L'Oreal Telescopic Mascara. And this time I'm using a brown mascara, just so it blends in with the lighter brown shades that I've used. And again, for that toned down look, I didn't want to use a black mascara, so instead I'm using a brown one. And here is the completed eye makeup. To bring back some warmth into my face, I'm going to be using the Sun-Drenched Bronzer. This is by Milani. This is a matte bronzer, so it doesn't have any shine to it and it doesn't have that orange tint, so you can almost use this as a contour, and that's exactly what I'll be doing with my nose. So to contour it, I'm just taking a little bit with a small flat shader brush just to add some structure to my nose. I'm going to be using a matte blush by ColourPop today. This is the Make Me Blush blush in Love Me Not. And for highlighter, again, I'm going to be using the Revlon Skin Lights Prismatic Highlighter in the shade Gilded Dawn. To complement the eye look, I'm using a beautiful rustic lipstick. This is a matte lipstick by Lady Burgundy in the shade Maha. Nice thing about neutral eye looks is you can combine it with any color lipstick. You can either go low-key and just wear something very nude on your lip, or you can go glamorous by using a red lip or a bold lip. And here is the completed look put together. I hope you enjoyed this video. Please do check out the description box for all the products that I used today, and do thumbs up if you enjoyed this video. And please consider subscribing if you're new here. I post several times a week. I love you guys so much, and I will see you soon with a brand new one. Bye guys.